कंडीशनर ट्रेनर। दिस ट्रेनर इज मैन्युफैक्चर्ड बाय टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। दिस डिस्क्राइब द जनरल साइकिल ऑफ एयर कंडीशनिंग। फ्रॉम दिस ट्रेनर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द वेपर कंप्रेशन साइकिल ऑफ एयर कंडीशनर, टू कैलकुलेट द सीओपी ऑफ एयर कंडीशनर एंड टू स्टडी द डिफरेंट एयर कंडीशनिंग प्रोसेस लाइक हीटिंग, कूलिंग, ह्यूमिडिफिकेशन, कूलिंग विद डीह्यूमिडिफिकेशन, कूलिंग विद ह्यूमिडिफिकेशन एंड हीटिंग विद डीह्यूमिडिफिकेशन। सो नाउ आई विल डिस्क्राइब सम जनरल थ्योरीज अबाउट द एयर कंडीशन। एयर कंडीशनिंग मे बी डिफाइंड एज द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिमूविंग हीट फ्रॉम एनी सब्सटेंस अंडर द कंट्रोल कंडीशंस। इट ऑल्सो इंक्लूड्स द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिड्यूसिंग एंड मेंटेन द टेम्परेचर ऑफ बॉडी बिलो द जनरल टेम्परेचर ऑफ इट्स सराउंडिंग। दिस इज वाइडली यूज फॉर कूलिंग स्टोरेज ऑफ चैम्बर, कूलिंग फॉर स्टोरेज चैम्बर्स इन विच प्रिफरेबली फूड ड्रिंक्स एंड मेडिसिन आर स्टोर्ड। सो नाउ वी मूव ऑन टू द डिस्क्रिप्शन अबाउट दिस ट्रेनर किट। The trainer kits, in this there are the on-off switches for compressor, blower, heater and boiler. This is the energy meter which calculates the wattage and power consumed by this AC. This is the temperature meter which describes temperatures of different locations from this cycle. This is the voltmeter which is supplied voltage to the AC. And this is the ampere meter which is the describes the load consumption from this AC. This is the control panel from setting the temperature and stop the AC. These are the pressure gauges which shows the suction pressure and delivery pressure from the compressor. And this is the LPHSP cutoff pressure switch. And these are the control valves which are used to flow the refrigerant inside the cycle. This is the rotameter which shows the reading of mass flow of air. This is the compressor unit which compresses the refrigerant. This is the condenser unit and condenser fan as well included in this unit. This is the evaporator unit. Inside this the blower output has combined and this is the ducting through which the cool air passed on. These are the dry and wet bulb temperature meters, thermometers which will be used to read the actual temperature of the surrounding. Now these are the filter and dryer and these are the capillary tube which are used in this cycles. Now we move on to the vapor compression cycle concept. The vapor compression cycle simply starts with the compressor unit. When the low pressure and temperature of refrigerant from the evaporator is drawn into the compressor through the inlet and suction valve, as it is compressed to high temperature and pressure, this high temperature and pressure vapor refrigerant is discharged into the condenser unit through these delivery pipes. The condenser unit or cooler consists of pipe in which the high pressure and temperature refrigerant is cooled and condensed. The refrigerant while passing through the condenser gives up the heat to the surrounding, which consists of condensing medium. In a normally case the condensing medium is air. Now the output of condenser fed to the capillary tube through this rotameter. The capillary tubes expand the liquid refrigerant at high pressure to the liquid refrigerant at low pressure, so that the major quantity of liquid refrigerant is passed into the evaporator. Now evaporator, it consists of coils of pipe in which the liquid vapor refrigerant at low pressure and temperature is evaporated and changed to vapor refrigerant at low temperature and pressure. In evaporating the liquid vapor refrigerant,
It absorbs the latent heat of vaporization from the medium which is to be cooled. Evaporator, the liquid refrigerant, by absorbing the heat into the vapor refrigerant, sent back into the compressor. And the cycle continuously repeats from compressor to condenser to capillary tubes and through evaporator. In evaporator, the blower passes the surrounding air from the evaporator section, and the air gives up the heat again, and cool air is passed through this ducting air, and which is passed in the room, and the room temperature decreases. Now we start the kit with this on-off button. Now to start this cycle, we first switch on the compressor unit and blower. After the set pressure, the compressor will automatically start in few minutes. On the control panel, we can see the temperature is set at 23 degrees. We can increase or decrease the temperature with these buttons. So for right now, we will set the temperature at 25 degrees. When the pressure is suitable, the compressor will start running. Before starting the unit, make sure all the control valves are opened. Now we will wait for compressor to start. Now the compressor has started. At this time we can see the load of compressor at the ampere meter and the blower also. At this time, note down the readings of suction pressure and delivery pressure and the temperature readings of different sections in which the potentiometer electric switch is given the temperature of different sections. At the point 1, it gives the inlet temperature of compressor. At point 2, it gives the outlet temperature of compressor. At point 3, it gives the outlet temperature of condenser. At point 4, it gives the input temperature to the evaporator. This is the inlet temperature of evaporator after the capillary tube. You can see the compressor starts working. At point 5, the temperature at the inlet of air duct. At point 6, the temperature of outlet of the air ducts. Now at this time, the inlet temperature of the compressor is around 43 degrees and the outlet temperature is around 60 degrees. The vapor, the refrigerant inside the compressor is compressed and the temperature compressed at high pressure, and the temperature due to the compression is increased. We can see at this temperature meter. This is the outlet temperature from the condenser. At this time, the temperature of refrigerant goes low and the output is fed to the rotor meter. Now you can note down the condensed refrigerant mass flow of air at this time by taking the rotor meter reading. Now the outlet from the rotor meter is coupled with the capillary tubes. At this capillary tubes, the condensed refrigerant changes to vapor from these capillary tubes and fed to the evaporator. Now the temperature at the inlet or the outlet of capillary will be shown at the point number 4. You can see the temperature of the refrigerant is now lower from the surrounding.
This low temperature refrigerant fed to the evaporator and coils of evaporator are less cool from the surrounding temperature. The inlet air pass through this cooled coils and the temperature of air goes down because the cooling coils absorb the heat from the air, which is the medium to be cooled. The inlet air is about 35 degrees and the outlet air is about near about the 35 degrees. After some time the cooling effect works and the outlet temperature goes down. At this time we can observe the readings from these DBT parameters, dry bulb thermometers and wet bulb thermometers, which to be placed in the air duct. We will take the outlet readings from this after some time as the thermometer works, and it takes about 1 minute to read the proper reading. By getting the different readings we can observe the cooling cycle is working with this AC unit. Now we will see the output from the DBT units, which are showing around temperature is 25 degrees in the dry bulb and as well 27 degrees around with the wet bulb, which is the set temperature at the control panel, which is 25 degrees. So that's how the AC working in the cooling mode. Now after taking the readings of suction pressure, delivery pressure, temperature of different locations, voltmeter and ampere meter, we will take the and rotameter, we will take the temperatures of DBT, which is the actual temperature. For this put this thermometers at the hook provided inside the air duct and place it for about 20 to 30 seconds as the thermometers need some time to work. At this time the cooling cycle is working and the cool air is passing through this air duct, which cools the surrounding. So the output from the DBT we can see is near about 25 degrees from the dry bulb, and also it is about 25 degrees from the wet bulb. So we can see the 25 degree is our set temperature at the control panel, and we get the cooled air is about 25 degrees from the air duct output. So this is the cooling cycle of air condition. The coefficient of performance and other readings can be calculated. The formulas are given in the manual. After taking all the readings you can easily calculate the COP of the reading of the air condition cycle. Now we move on to the heating cycle of this air conditioning trainer. For this, always make sure the compressor is off before turning on the heater. So we turn off the compressor. Lower need to working at this time. Now we power on the heater. You can see the load is increased due to heater. Heater is installed in this air duct. Now we take the readings from DVTs at the output of air duct. And wait for the readings to be stable in the thermometers. You can see the heater inside the duct. The heater is located inside the duct. Now at the outlet of this air duct, the warm air is passing through, which warms the surrounding. Now we note the DVT. Here we can see the temperature is rises around 30 degrees in a few seconds. So you can observe the heating cycle is working from this air conditioner trainer. Note down the old readings which have already taken. You also see the temperature of air duct outlet at the temperature meter, which is up now 41 degrees. The inlet temperature is 37 degrees. You can easily see the difference of 3 degrees from inlet to outlet, which is air passing through the heater increases the temperature. Now for the humidification, the boiler is provided in this panel. The boiler on off switch is here. We can on the boiler switch. The humidification, the boiler is on. We can see the load changes at the ampere meter. It's increased due to boiler has started. The boiler is located at this location. Make sure always the boiler is filled with the water before starting up. The steam generated through this boiler is supplied to the inside the air duct. At here the humidification or the humidified air is passes through this outlet of air duct. This is the process of heating and humidification. For getting the humidity rate, you can also use an humidity indicator or humidity sensor if you have. For cooling with dehumidification and humidification, we are going to explain this cycle. For this, make sure the compressor is on, blower is on. Now as we on the boiler, you can see boiler is on, load is increased on the ampere meter. The boiler has started and after some time the steam is generated. The steam now will be passed in the air duct, which increase the humidity in the air coming from the air duct outlet. If we want to control the humidification, we can set the temperatures lower and higher as required. So in humidification and dehumidification with cooling effect, you can note down all the readings and calculate the different COPs of this cycle and efficiency of this cycle. Also you can read the temperatures of dry bulb thermometer and wet bulb thermometer, and you will get the output. And note down these readings in the table provided in the user manual. Now I will explain you the safety precautions which have to be taken to and with working with this unit. So always make sure when you start the unit, the all on-off switches are in off condition. Make sure all the valves are open before opening, starting the unit. Always start blower first, then start compressor or heater, which process is to be experiment. Do not shut off any of valve immediately or sudden effect, which can be damage the rotameter glass tube. And always make sure the power supply is not less than 180 volts, and frequency must be around 50 hertz or 60 hertz while operating with this air conditioning kit. So now that's it for today. Any queries, you can refer to the user manual, and you can contact also to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you for today.